Hey, happy Thursday, everyone. Mark again here at Weatherman Plus. These storms have gotten a lot worse overnight, everyone. Not only what's going on over here along the East Coast for our tropics, our severe weather is really kicking in. So for today and for tomorrow, we have a dangerous line of storms that's going to start building up. And this is bringing a threat for tornadoes, damaging winds, and hail as well. And what's building up over here along the East Coast? A big shift. But it's not what you think. I have new information in the video. I'm going to show you exactly what you can expect from all of this. Make sure you subscribe and follow along for updates. Now you also can see that we have a strong little tropical wave right over here, right towards Eastern Caribbean, coming from the MDR. And I'm showing that the same high pressure that is squeezing this over here along the East Coast, limiting time that this could form, is the same high pressure that's going to expand and bring this into the Eastern Pacific also. So not only can we expect Gil, more than likely can expect Henrietta after that, and maybe another one after that. Now for today, you still have 100 to over 100 degree temperatures kicking in for the Southwest and California, while you still have these 90s stretching all the way into Canada, all the way across towards Ohio Valley, the Mid-Mississippi Valley, and towards the south. Even a little bit towards the southeast for Georgia and the Carolinas. And with your heat index value, you still could feel like over 100 degrees for the coast of Texas and going through Louisiana for today. And you can see for tonight, we do have those 50s and 60s coming back down towards the west, also over here across Ohio Valley and towards the northeast. Now, if you remember my update, this is where we had that big high ridge of heat, the cool down on both sides, and you know what's coming next if you have been following me. And for tomorrow, 4th of July, you still have below average temperatures still kicking through Texas, a little bit of Oklahoma and southern Kansas, but you have all these 90s that's still going to be persisting all the way towards the north, and it's going to go further towards the east for tomorrow, and you're still over 100 degrees for the southwest. And with your heat indices for tomorrow, you're still going to feel over 100 degrees for Louisiana, maybe a little bit of Texas as well. But over here for the north central and the upper Midwest, you could be feeling like over 100 degrees as well. Now, yesterday was relatively quiet. We did get almost 30 wind reports and a few hail reports. But unfortunately, it's not going to stay that way. So for today, you have chances for thunderstorms in any of this green area, but your severe weather is going to be to the north. You even have that 2% chance for a tornado. Like I told you yesterday, it could be a 2% added. There it is. So here's your cities and states at risk for a potential tornado for today. This is going to be way later this evening than overnight for tomorrow is where it gets worse. You have the wind threat for today as well in a few areas. Also over here for Wisconsin, Minnesota, for Iowa. You have some storms that are swinging around the high pressure while we get this trough, and it's going to come downwards towards Wisconsin. Might bring you a little bit of wind gusts. Also for the northeast, you have some storms moving through that could bring you some damage and winds as well. So here's your cities and states at risk for damage and winds for today. And your hail threat in the same areas, but it's going to be stronger on those storm cells later this evening for North Dakota. Even chances for 2 inches or greater in that black area. So here's your cities and states at risk for a possible hail threat for today. And you can see overall pattern here on your vortices. So you get this big high ridge that's still kicking across the north. While you get some storm cells that move across for this morning from North Dakota, you also get some over here for the northeast for New England that moves through. But what comes on later this evening as this comes around this high ridge of heat is going to bring right back around towards Wisconsin, but they are going to start weakening down a little bit, but you could get some damaging winds out of those. While this builds up for later on, coming from the shortwave trough on the northwest, and this is going to bring a big pile of storms all the way across for the upper Midwest, the north central, the northern Rockies, and just come across for tonight and for tomorrow. Tomorrow is where this starts intensifying and really comes in with a trough, a lot of winds aloft, and brings you a lot more storms, especially for tomorrow. While this over here along the southeast starts getting a lot of rotation in it as you go through for tomorrow and Saturday. And you can see on the latest update with HRRR, those storm cells that come across for earlier this morning are a little bit weak coming through North Dakota, also into Canada. But you do get some storm cells that brings through all the way from noon and beyond for New England, for Vermont, New Hampshire, and Maine. And it does build up a little bit for New York going through the coast of the Northeast. So you can watch out for that. That could bring chances for some damaging winds. While this builds right across the North Central, right across the Northern Rockies. Now, once you go through later tonight, around 8 or 9 o'clock, your winds aloft start getting stronger. So there's your storm cells as you go through for the northern Rockies and northern central, and that does swing right back around early in the morning, a little bit isolated in nature, but bringing some strong storms towards Wisconsin, bringing chances for damaging winds with those as well, as that goes right off into northern Minnesota into Canada. Now for tomorrow, this is where it strengthens. This is where your winds get stronger. Now you got that trough coming through and you get a lot of scattered storms across the northwest. But look at this line of storms really building, where you get some damaging winds. You also getting some chances for some tornadoes as that comes through for tomorrow evening. And it sticks around all night for tomorrow evening, and it will be right back again for Saturday for Minnesota, Iowa, and Wisconsin. I will show you. And when you look for your winds aloft, your 850 millibars, you can see the winds start strengthening up on those line of storms as you go later tonight and overnight. So this will make it more robust storms, bringing more of a threat as you go overnight into the early morning hours. Then again for tomorrow, it comes right back again. Showing all together, you could get some winds across the northeast into New England. 40 miles per hour wind gusts in the green. It might be an isolated 50 in there in that yellow, maybe a little bit stronger. While you get a lot of winds all across the western U.S., all across the central, the north central, the northern Rockies. Look at this. You have 40 miles per hour wind gusts in the green. You have 50 in the orange, 60 in the red, and maybe an isolated 70 in there. Very strong storms bring a lot of strong damage and winds in the least. You have the threat for hail as well, even chances for large hail in North Dakota. It's not showing super large in the latest run for today. And you see those storms could bring some hail across Wisconsin, also for Northeast and New England on those line of storms. And for tomorrow, it's going to come right back again. Showing this line of storms really strengthens as it goes through Canada. So for tomorrow, you could see thunderstorms in any of this green section, but your severe weather is going to be on that line of storms with those winds aloft. Even chances for tornadoes for tomorrow. You have a 2% in that line of storms. So here's your cities and states at risk for tornado threat for tomorrow. Not showing any hail on that hail threat, but it is going to be a wind threat that's going to come with that as well. So here's your cities and states at risk for possible severe or damaging winds for tomorrow, for Friday. And as you go through Saturday, you got a chance for thunderstorms in any of this green area. But as that trough starts building in the northwest, you're going to get a line of storms building over here in this marginal, plus what's coming across for the upper Midwest. So you do have a 5% for severe weather for Saturday. So far, here's your cities and states at risk for that. Showing it does weaken down as it goes further towards the east. So it's mainly going to be isolated severe wind gusts, which is going to be possible across the upper Midwest and the central high plain. And they do weaken down as they go towards east, but they're initially very strong storms. So you can see here with rapid refresh that we can see past what HRRR is showing. Showing those storms coming across for tomorrow morning is a little more robust than what HRRR is showing. That's what rapid refresh does. It always makes it look bigger than actually what we see when it actually comes into fruition. Still, we'll keep this in mind, but HRRR is not seeing that. And as we go through for the big event for tomorrow, you see how this grows, just like we're seeing with HRRR. But as it's moved further towards the east, it's bringing more of a damage and wind event with that as it goes all the way till Saturday morning. Then for Saturday, it sparks right back up again. And we might even get a tornado threat if any of this shows true when we get closer to it. We have some discrete cells that's popping up for Wisconsin. Also some strong cells for Iowa over here for southern Minnesota. While you get a damage and wind event potentially for northern Wisconsin going through the UP of Michigan. So if this shows true with HRRR for Saturday, we could see an upgrade. And you see the latest with the Euro. You look at your vortice. Those strong storms coming through all the way for Saturday. But we started getting some spinning coming across the southeast. And it really starts ramping up from Friday into Saturday into Sunday. Going right up the coast. Then going right back out. And that's the latest from the Euro. Remember, the Euro has been way more accurate this year than the GFS. I will show you what the GFS is showing. I'm sure you're going to see a lot of it. It is not trending. Matter of fact, when I show you the update with the GFS, it agrees with the European. But still, as this goes right up the coast, you can see that tornado threat increase for South Carolina and North Carolina, maybe even portions of Virginia right there, and maybe for the Delmarva as it scoots away if that comes into fruition the way it's showing. So your latest tropical update, you can see you have Flossie is weakening down, still going towards cooler waters and a lot of dry air. But you have over here this disturbance that's 80% in the next 7 days, 30% in the next 48 hours. This will become Gill, and it will go out through the Pacific. It has a good chance to strengthen very strong as well. Then that next storm cell, as you see in the MDR by the Caribbean, that's going to come this way as well and get pushed out by the high pressure. And that's going to be the next named storm you're going to see over here. For the Atlantic side, you can see how this dramatically shifted in the last 24 hours. So it went from this over towards isolated towards the Carolinas to stretching out a little bit further. And now it's at 50% in the next 7 days, 10% in the next 48 hours. But what you need to look at is the details. You see how it says a chance for a subtropical or a tropical depression. not a tropical storm. Same thing is said yesterday. So remember, if it's not a tropical storm, it will not get a name. It's going to bring some flooding regardless. I'm showing that went down with the trend I've been showing you, but also showing this will drift northward and northeastward, bringing that heavy rainfall no matter what. And now you can see the big change. So chance for a tropical depression is now at 100% right over here by the Carolinas. While this moves generally right on the coast and goes out through the northeast. Now the intensity of this system depends on how long it is over water and how long it's going to be over land. If it stays on water just long enough, it could stay stronger and you could actually see that Chantal. But what we've been seeing is this has been trending going inland, getting pushed by the high pressure still, and it's going to be right on land where it's going to be around the edge and not really intensify. Chance for a tropical storm is at 30 to 40% chance as it strengthens and goes away. You see that? Not really right here along the coast. So if you do get a tropical storm, it will be further offshore, no threat to anyone. But you can also see in 72 hours, that's where it has its best chance. And as you go 4 to 5 days, that's where it gets pushed inland and shows that it rides the coast right inland as you go 5 to 6 days. Then 7 days, it starts pulling away out into the Atlantic. So let's go by the latest ensembles. Look right here with the European as you go through Friday. This way, you have your best chance for any kind of formation. Then it starts getting pushed inland because you're getting squeezed by this high pressure. And this is where it has a chance to where it can start strengthening up as it goes inland. Now, if you don't see all these ensembles showing that, you're just seeing one here and there showing the strength. It's not really showing all of them. But if it stays over water, that's where it could stay stronger. If it gets pushed inland, that's where it will weaken back down. See that one right along the coast by the water? That's the only one that's showing any strength as that pulls away later on. The rest of them is showing a tropical depression. So let's go through the latest deterministic and see exactly what the trend is. You can see here with the European, not only what's going on in the Pacific, but you do have a chance for a low pressure to build. It's very big, it's very broad. As you go through Saturdays where it tightens up the best, then it gets pushed inland and it runs out of time. Just a tropical depression that's coming through. No storm or anything stronger. So let's go for the trend. Here's a Canadian model. You can see it's getting a big, broad low pressure. It's showing a little bit stronger, like 1,012 millibar, as it weakens right back down and goes right inland. Now let me show you the GFS. I'm sure you're gonna see a lot of this today. So as it starts building up, you can see you get gill forming in the Pacific. Then it starts forming up right there where everything else takes it right inland and starts weakening down. But instead of weakening down, which by the way, shows gill getting very strong over here in the Pacific, only according to the GFS. Instead of going inland, it comes back out. Like the high pressure don't stay that long. And GFS is the only one that shows this. I will show you an update. You'll see what I'm talking about. Then it intensifies as it goes out through the Atlantic. While you get another one in the Pacific. This is that wave that you see going through the Caribbean. Everything's getting pushed out by this big high pressure. And maybe another one later on going in the Eastern Pacific. So let's go by the latest update because GFS has not been accurate all hurricane season. You can see the new information showing just like the rest of the models, getting very weak, going inland right along the coast. But you do not see that intensification like you saw on the 0Z. You see it weak, a tropical depression, just like the rest of the models. So you might see the bigger one and a stronger one all day. Just remember what the new information is that Weatherman Plus showed you, that is not trending. And if these keep going into the Eastern Pacific like the way it's looking, you're gonna have a lot of names. First we got Gil, then we got Henrietta. We might even have another one after that. Now for accuracy, I'm gonna show you what all the ensembles show so you can see exactly what I'm showing you, that GFS was a Lone Ranger on that icon. None of those are seeing any of that. So literally as you go 72 hours, you see the chances for a tropical depression, a strong one or a weak tropical storm. Down here on the bottom, you can see your millibars from a high pressure to the low pressure, and you can see your chances. Now they have one here that shows you could get a tropical storm. They have another here that shows you could get a tropical storm. But once again, we're talking about two, maybe three right here as I back this up so you can see that they all kind of go right inland, getting squeezed by that high pressure. So you see how the rest of them is just showing something very weak. It runs out of time. This one does what you see this morning on GFS on the 0Z, and it curves right around, and it does not go that far inland. So that's what you need to watch out for. Because if it does not go that far inland, It will stay in the warm waters and it will start strengthening. However, what I'm seeing is the trend is it's going inland, maybe come out later and strengthen later. So we will keep our eye on it. Look at the other 25, because there's 50 members with the European, showing not only a lot of weakness, and these 25 a lot weaker, where it goes anywhere from a upper level low to where it's just a wave passing by. So look at this. You can see the rest of these showing not really a chance for formation. You get one or two here where it tries to show anything a little bit stronger than a tropical depression. The rest of these show maybe a late formation along the coast, and then it goes right up that coast. So we do need to watch out for that pause break. It's not trending. You see the rest of them is already gone or coming out to northeast. But we do see this little scenario here, and that's what the GFS is seeing. And remember, the GFS did correct itself and brought itself back around to the European. If there's any dramatic changes on this, I will update you this afternoon. So let's talk rainfall, because other than a chance for tornadoes coming off of the banding, this is a main thing that's going to be a main threat, and it has moved towards a trend that I have been showing you. And you can see the latest update for the next 7 days. And you just get 2 or 3 inches of rainfall across Florida, what we've been seeing here on my channel. 1 inch right along the coast, maybe 2 inches for North Carolina as this comes back offshore. This is what Weather Prediction Center. Look with the European. European's been showing this for quite some time. Matter of fact, a lot of people in Florida probably hasn't even seen no rain and probably won't see no rain. This is a 7-day forecast. So thank you so much for your time, everybody. That has been your weather update. If you appreciate any of this information, please think about hitting that like button down below. Let others see the real information of what's going on and not just this GFS model run, which I'm sure is going to be everywhere on the internet for today. Thank you again for your time. And before I go, a quick word from our Father, everyone, Philippians 4:8-9. Finally, brethren, whatsoever things are true, whatsoever things are honest, whatsoever things are just, whatsoever things are pure, whatsoever things are lovely, whatsoever things are of good report, if there be any virtue and if there be any praise, think on these things. Those things which ye have both learned and received and heard and seen in me, do, and the God of peace shall be with you. Amen. Have a great day, everyone. May God bless every single one of you. And remember, if it does get any worse or any more big changes, I will see you this afternoon for another update. I will make sure you will stay updated during this tropical season. And remember, above all things, all glory goes to God, our Father in heaven, Yahweh. And I always hope he keeps you safe every single day of your life and forever. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Have a great day, everybody. Remember, if you want to follow me or support me, all the links are in the description.